हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज महेश पाठक एंड वेलकम टू पाठक्स माइक्रोबायोलॉजी एकेडमी। इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट टैक्सोनॉमिकल एड्स। दिस इज द फिफ्थ एंड द लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर व्हिच वी हैव बीन स्टडीइंग एंड द चैप्टर नेम इज द लिविंग वर्ल्ड। ओके, सो इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस सम टैक्सोनॉमिकल एड्स व्हिच आर यूज्ड इन स्टडी पर्पस और टैक्सोनॉमिकल स्टडीज व्हिच इज यूज्ड बाय सम बायोलॉजिस्ट। And there are some various techniques to study of such plants and animals. So that we are going to discuss in this lecture. Okay. So we are having this presentation. Let me start it again. Sorry. Okay. So let's understand. What is taxonomical aids? So to study the living and the dead organism, we must have some techniques and procedures which we can use for to study and to classify them and identify the living organisms, which are we have seen that there are vast number of species on this planet. So to classify them and study them accurately, we must have some techniques and procedures and some methods to conserve that specimen of particular plant or animal, and by using that specimen we can study that particular type of plants or animals or any type of organism. So we are having these techniques which are used or procedures which are used in taxonomical studies. So these studies we can procedure we can call it as taxonomical aids. So first technique is herbarium, to make herbarium of plants. So let's understand first what is herbarium. Okay, let me start the slideshow again. This is herbarium. Okay, so what is herbarium? Herbariums are simply in herbarium sheets we take a specimen of particular plant. We dry them, we press them onto a sheet or a paper, and that on that sheet we can write we write some information regarding that particular specimen, where from where we have collected that particular specimen, the name of that specimen, or both names, the local name and the scientific name of that specimen. So these are some informations we write on the herbarium sheets, and those sheets, more than let's say 100 sheets are we place and arrange them according to their sequence, and we make herbarium file or herbarium. Okay, so in herbarium sheets, like here you can see in this image, so this is herbarium sheet, and on which you can see the specimen which is dried and conserved and pressed on this paper. Okay, so on this sheet, on the same sheet we have the box, the chart, and in that chart the name and the collector name, when that particular specimen was taken, and both name, biological and scientific names, and much more is written on that particular type of sheet. Okay, so that sheet is known as herbarium sheet, and by arranging such number of sheets and making the file, we can call hold that file herbarium. Okay, so that is what herbarium is all about. Here you can see this lady is studying the herbarium. Okay, so this is very important procedure used by some biologists to study some living some plants. Okay, then the second taxonomical aid is botanical garden. Okay, what is botanical garden? You may have seen in your colleges or schools we have botanical gardens. So in botanical gardens, what is difference between herbarium and botanical gardens? In botanical gardens, we we grow some plants and we can study the living plants. Okay, we provide them environment like their natural habitats, and we grow and cultivate plants. Okay, and on that plant we can write their information, where the name of the plant and the local name of the plant. Okay, so here in this image you can see the botanical garden. So much variety of plants are grown in the same place. Okay, so a particular place is there in your institute or colleges. So there we are having some variety of plants, and that place is called as botanical garden. So, and that the each and every individual plant have local and scientific names are written on them in botanical gardens. Okay, so for taxonomical studies, these botanical gardens are very much useful. Then again, the educational institute have some museums in which dead plants and animals are conserved in some like these chambers, these boxes. Okay, so here you can see in this box the specimen is conserved. The plants and animals are conserved in laboratories or in museums. So to study them for taxonomical studies. So museum is also one of the taxonomical aids. So here is another image, the beautiful image of the museum in which plants are conserved. Here you can see the museum. So these are some taxonomical aids. Another is zoological parks. Okay, so you may have visited in your life that zoological parks are also there, in which the living organisms, living animals are conserved. We conserved some species of particular type of living animals, and we provide them some natural habitats so that they can live more easily in the environment. Okay, so that place is in that place we conserve some rare species or some living animals, and that place is called as zoological park. So these are some taxonomical aids which we have seen in this lecture. So this was the last lecture of the chapter Living World, guys. We will take one or two more lectures to revise this chapter again. We are making 11 biology lecture series. If you like our work and if you like our lectures, please hit the like button and subscribe the channel and share this video to your friends and family or contacts. Okay, thank you so much for your support.